So at first we are studying about silica sand. Silica sand is basically a part of quartz rock. So this quartz rock over time through the work of water and wind has been broken down into tiny granules. So this quartz rock has broken down into tiny granules. These granules collectively are called as silica sand. The main important properties of silica sand are it has high fusion point up to 1760 degrees Celsius. So it can hold a temperature of 1760 degrees Celsius. And then low rate of thermal expansion. So when it is subjected to high temperature, the thermal expansion is low in the silica sand. And it produces suitable cores and mold compatible with all pouring temperatures. So we can produce the cores and it is mold compatible for all alloying systems. So silica sand composition, it has one atom of silicon and two atom of oxygen. So one atom of silicon and two atom of oxygen, so it will become SiO2. In this we are studying clay. So this is the sand particle, collective sand particle. In this sand particle it has a size of 2.02 0.05 mm. So in this sand particles there are other two particles. First one is silt particle, which has size of 0.02 0.002 mm. These particles are called silt particles. And then there is another category, that is clay particle, which has size of 0.002 mm. So that totally means the smallest particle in a sand particle system. The smallest particle in a sand particle system is called as clay particle. We can see here the clay particle, which is very small, silt bigger than clay particle, and total sand particle, it constitutes both silt and clay. So this is the clay. Types of moulding sands. There are totally 8 types in moulding sands. First one is foundry green sand and dry sand, loam sand, parting sand, basing sand, baking sand, system sand and core sand. So let's study each of these sands. Foundry sand, or we call it as green sand, it is a mixture of silica sand with 15 to 25% of clay. So it is a mixture of silica sand, so that we have studied silica sand, and 15 to 25% of clay. 15 to 25% of clay and 6 to 8% of water. So that combines together is a foundry green sand. This sand is used in wet condition. This is very important. This foundry green sand is used in wet condition because there is already water present in it for making the mold. Green sand molds are not dried when the metal poured in them in the wet condition. So they are pouring the metal in the wet condition only. So it is easily worked with hand. We can work it with the hand to make desired shapes. And it is used for producing small to medium sized molds which are not very complex. So this is about green sand. Dry sand. Dry sand is the green sand that dried or baked after preparing the mold. So dry sand is nothing but same green sand which is dried or baked after preparing the mold. So after preparing the mold, we are going to dry this. So that becomes the dry sand and is used for producing medium to large size molds. Loam sand. Loam sand containing up to 50% of clay. So we know already clay is the smallest particle in the sand system, which is of size 0.002 mm. So in the loam sand, there is 50% of clay included. It is of plastic paste form. So it is a plastic paste form and is used for large castings and mostly for the gray cast iron casting. So for gray cast iron casting, we are using the loam sand. Parting sand. It consists of fine grained clay free dried silica sand, sea sand or burnt sand with some parting compounds. So parting sand is mainly either silica sand or sea sand or burnt sand with some parting compounds like charcoal, limestone, talc and calcium phosphate. So that constitutes the parting sand. The main application of parting sand is we have pattern, and when we put the sand on this, to avoid this pattern to be stick with the sand, we are using the parting sand. The name is part. So it will part, that means for easy removal of pattern, this parting sand is used. That is here. To ensure that green sand does not stick to the pattern, the cope and drag parts easily separated for removing the pattern without causing any damage to the mold. So to easy removal of pattern, the parting sand is used in between the pattern and the molding sand. And the next one is facing sand. So the name is facing. It will face, that we see, comes in direct contact with the molten metal when poured. So facing sand, it will come in direct contact with molten metal. So this is the molten metal here, and facing sand will come in direct contact with the molten metal. That means it faces the molten metal. That is why the name is facing sand. Facing sand is the sand which covers the pattern all around it. So it will cover the pattern all around it. The rimming box filled with ordinary floor sand. So once the facing sand is covered, remaining sand is filled with floor sand. It is made of silica sand and clay without the addition of any used sand. So it is made up of silica sand and clay. So we know already what is silica sand and clay. Has capacity to withstand high temperature. Obviously, the facing sand should have the capacity to withstand high temperature. And next one is backing sand. See the difference here. Facing, it will face. In backing, it will back. So it is used to back beside the facing sand. So first layer is facing sand, and facing sand back is backing sand. After that, we have molding sand, that is here. So backing sand used to back beside the facing sand and to fill up remaining volume. Because of the color, backing sand also called as black sand. So it is also called as black sand because of its color. So the burnt coal powder is used as baking sand. Burnt coal powder. And the last one is system sand. This is the sand used in mechanized foundries. No separate basing sand is used. So in mechanization, that means when we want automatic foundry, we are using system sand, where there is no separate basing sand. There is no basing sand. The such sand is called as system sand. Thank you for watching. In the next video, we are going to study pattern allowances. Those are sinkage or contraction allowance with some problems on it, and drift or taper allowance, machining or pinching allowance, distortion or camber allowance, and wrapping allowance with detailed explanation. Thank you for watching.